Hello, good morning to you, all of you. Good morning to all of you. Here is Mr. Siddhant Rao, my grandson. We are sitting in Delhi in his own house. Now we are going to give prediction of March 2018, part 2. Siddhant, please continue.
On March 1st, 2018, in the Rashi chart, Sun, Mercury, Venus, along with Ascendant, are in Aquarius. Rahu is in Cancer. Moon is in Leo. Jupiter is in Libra.
Moon is in, correct, correct, yes.
Mars is in Scorpio. Saturn is in Sagittarius. And Ketu is still in
Capricorn.
Capricorn. On March 1st, 2018, Mesha Rashi. Some disturbance in happiness. You may be mentally sick due to the presence of Rahu and Moon in your fourth house in Bhavacharita chart. Cancer and your mother may be eccentric during the period. Children are good at mentally and educationally. Sweet relationship and spouse and partners. Some accidents may be probes, low in Bhagya. Some sorts of lethargic attitudes in profession and ample of profits expected from father, government, boss, in the office, friends, and from ladies also. In fact, you may undergo visiting temples also. Rishabha Rashi. Happiness is awaited. If you are admitted to the hospital, discharge is awaited. There may be disputes between you and the spouse, some sorts of hurdles in your bhagya, and in professional front, promotion or sweet news awaited. Mithuna Rashi. Sudden jump in income, sweet communication, happiness from the children, no enemies, some hurdles in the relationship and the partnership. Bhagya from father, government, friends and relatives and also from ladies are all awaited during this period. Karka Rashi. Your mind is not under your control. You appear to be mad for the society people as Moon and Rahu together in Bhavacharita chart. Very good income or money flow as it is your birthright, I believe. Happiness in the house front. Disputes between you and your children. No further enemies. There may be divorce type of situations between you and your spouse. In the Rashi chart of 2nd March 2018, Ascendant along with Moon is in Leo, Jupiter is in Libra, Mars is in Scorpio, Saturn is in Sagittarius, Ketu is in Capricorn, Mercury with and Sun are in Aquarius, Venus is in Pisces, and Rahu is in Cancer. Simha Rashi. Absolute happiness and pleasant day. Sweet communication and short travel disturbances in the relationship with your mother. Children are very lazy in studies. Good relationship with your spouse, government, friends and relatives and also with ladies. You may be profited by friends and relatives and happy news at professional front. There may be investments on land and house properties also. Kanya Rashi. Maybe foreign travels or distant travels over the sea expected. Good income, very courageous attitude, sluggish in happiness, all seen during the period. Children are very lazy. And from spouse, you may get some money flow. In professional front, some sweet news are awaited, including promotion. Your profit may be plowed back for your travels. Tula Rashi. Your personality is pleasing. And also your communication carries religious matters. You may be getting unnecessarily angry and somewhat slow in your attitude. Your children are good at studies and may be got through in examinations. Your spouse brings happiness and also your mother. Mother is the cause of your profit. Vrishchika Rashi. You are unnecessarily getting angry and disturbed mentally. Mostly time will be passed by visiting temples, low income flow, happiness in house, from mother, friends, from father, friends and relatives, government boss, and from ladies also. Happiness from spouse, sudden jump in bhagya. Dhanur Rashi, very slow in your attitude and nature. Some disturbances in money flow. Very courageous attitude. Happiness in house, front and profit on the day under reference. And extra expenditure on investments on lands and house property. Makara Rashi, promotion of sweet news from professional front. Profit from the investments of the land and house properties. Good income flow from government boss, friends and relatives and from ladies. There may be disputes between you and your mother. Children bring some income to you and mother may be indisposed. Aquarius Rashi, which is already spent. Mina Rashi, you may have to face some hurdles and may not be happy so long. Jupiter in 8th house.
So long as Jupiter in 8th house from your Rashi till 12th October 2018.
You may be profited by the investment in lands and house properties. Your professional front may be having union problems. Your profits may be affected and your expenditure may be good for the cause. In the Rashi chart of 3rd March 2018, Ascendant is in Leo, Moon is in Virgo, Jupiter is in Libra, Mars is in Scorpio, Saturn is in Sagittarius, Ketu is in Capricorn, Sun is in Aquarius, Venus along with Mercury is in Pisces and Rahu is in Cancer. Mina Rashi, here you may observe that Lakshmi Narayan Yoga created in your Rashi and hence your image will be up in the society. Your children are good at educational front. Your relationship with the spouse will be good as Moon in Virgo and in Uttara Falguni Nakshatra Charan 4. Jupiter being the Lord, Lagna Lord of in 8th house and hence you may have some health issues coming up to 12th of October 2018 as Jupiter will be in Libra till that day. You may be still profited in your investments in land and house properties as Mars in your 9th house. Since Saturn in your 10th house, you may have to face hurdles in your professional front. You may be incurring some expenditure for your father regarding his health front. 4th, in the Rashi chart of 4th March 2018, Ascendant along with Sun is in Aquarius. Venus along with Mercury is in Pisces. Rahu is in Cancer. Moon is in Virgo. Jupiter is in Libra. Mars is in Scorpio. Saturn is in Sagittarius and Ketu is in Capricorn. In fact, 4th March predictions will also be like 1st, 2nd and 3rd March only. On 6th March 2018, in the Rashi chart, Ascendant is in Leo. Jupiter along with Moon is in Libra. Mars is in Scorpio. Saturn is in Sagittarius. Ketu is in Capricorn. Sun is in Aquarius. Venus along with Mercury is in Pisces. And Rahu is in Cancer.
Here Jupiter and Moon forms one yoga which is called as Gajakesari Yoga. Okay? And Mercury and Venus forming one yoga, that is called as
Lakshmi Narayan Yoga.
Very good. Mercury and Sun causing yoga, that is called as Budhaditya Yoga. Buddha Aditya Yoga. Okay? Now you start. Mesha Rashi.
Expenditure for the good cause and may be exploring opportunities for abroad. Relationship with mother will be good as Gajakesari Yoga formed in Libra. There may be some accidents in your vehicle driving, so please take care. Your bhagya will be slow. Your professional front may be having some hindrances. Your profits are mainly due to from your father, from boss, from government. Vrishabha Rashi, you may move to new rental house or new house itself. There may be problems in your health. Your relationship with your spouse may be strained. You may be getting promotion news from your boss. You may be we get in good profit?